When you're making hair in ZBrush, first it's a good idea to look at a 2D reference image and trace all the major hair shapes that you can see. Then you need to go to your model and create a base for your hair. This involves sculpting out all the major shapes that you outlined in your 2D reference image. This doesn't need to be super detailed, it just needs to be able to hold the hair strands once you create your hairbrush. So to create our hairbrush, first we need to start with a simple primitive. If you don't already have one in your scene, you can go to Subtool, Append, and append it in a cylinder, sphere, or cube. Hide everything else, and then select just that one subtool. Now we'll go down to Initialize, and we need to change the Z res to 3, and the Y resolution to 1, and hit Q, cube. Now ZBrush has created a nice little rectangle based on our specifications in the Initialize tab. If we turn on our polyframe button and we hover around our object, we can see that it's made of multiple polygroups, which is not what we want. So we want to hit Ctrl W and it's going to make everything one polygroup. If we turn off perspective mode and we snap to top view holding Shift, we can hold Ctrl, Alt, and Shift and drag out this red box that will hide anything inside of it. Press Ctrl W again and it will polygroup anything that's visible. Then we'll hold Ctrl, Alt, and Shift again and hide the second section. Press Ctrl W one more time to make another polygroup out of what's visible, then hold Ctrl and Shift, click outside of your object, and it will show everything. And now we have three groups, the top, the bottom, and the middle. This represents three sections of the hair strand. If we look at the strand from the side, we can also scale it down just a little bit because this controls how thick our hair strand is going to be. Now that we have our polygroups set up, we need to go into the brush menu, go to the bottom, and click Create Insert Mesh, and select New. As you can see in the top left, ZBrush just took this subtool that we created and turned it into a brush. And the name of that brush is actually the same name as our subtool, so you can change the name of your subtool and it will name the brush. Now we need to go into the stroke menu and go to curve and turn curve mode on. Then we need to go to our brush menu, go to modifiers, and turn on try parts and weld points. Weld points is going to make sure that our strand is connected as we draw it along the curve. Then go back to the stroke menu and go to curve modifiers. Turn on size, and below that there's a button that says curve falloff. If you click it, you get this little graph. You want to drag the dot on the right side all the way to the bottom, and then drag the dot on the left side just below the top. This will make it so your hair strand has some thickness at the beginning, and it tapers to a point at the end. And that is it. Now you have your very own hairbrush. Just be sure to go back into your brush palette, go to the bottom left, and click Save As to save it as a custom brush. If you hover your cursor away from your hair strand and change your brush size, when you click on the curve again, it will change the size of the hair strand. Also, if you click and hold on the strand and then hold Shift, you can drag your mouse along the curve and it will straighten it out. This is incredibly useful for preserving your hair strands because if you were to hold Shift and use your regular smooth brush, it would crush your mesh like this. And we definitely don't want that. So this is just a simple hairbrush, but what does this mean for creating custom hairbrushes? This means that you can stack geometry and go crazy with anything that you want as a subtool and turn it into your own custom hairbrush. Just make sure that you are separating it into three separate polygroups, top, middle, and bottom, and it should work fine. I hope you found this video helpful, and let me know if you were able to create your own custom hairbrush. If you enjoyed this tutorial, don't forget to subscribe to my channel and turn on notifications. Don't forget to like this video as well to help my channel out. If you'd like to see more videos like this in the future, leave me a comment down below, and until next time, thank you guys.